If I didn't know there were orc ships raiding to the west, I'd mistake this for a placid beach.
At least the orcs make a bit of noise when they attack. It's dark-dealing sorcerers that'll strike with neither warning nor mercy.
A bit quiet. I noticed the intro was a bit quiet as well when I recorded the other day, so let's have a quick look at the audio options. Cinematics, that needs to go up.
Voice. Stop it, you hear, or I'll box your ear!
My love, my own, my Belagor, embrace me, do!
There we go. I think that'll do. Oh, so we got to apply it, Nick.
What do you think you're doing?
There we go. I think that'll do. Oh, forgot to apply it, Nick. Special arrows are the milk and butter of the more experienced marksman. First, the crafty ranger makes his own arrowheads from the teeth of the fallen. A special property of these arrowheads, particularly as when combined with potions, it is not to be underestimated. Okay. Special arrows are the milk and butter of the more experienced marksman. First, the crafty ranger makes his own arrowheads from the teeth of the fallen. A special property of these arrowheads, particularly as when combined with potions. Which is not to be underestimated. Okay. Mess over these settings a little bit. Pop out, that's what I wanted. Here we go, first fight, I think.
Source hunters, how did they find us?
Take the stone to the temple. These whelps will be easy to crush.
As you say, Madam Conduit.
Arise, fair dead. Seize upon our enemies.
We'll be right back.
we go. Right, get the Spidey up first of all, I think. Yes, I know this is our hot bar. Turn there. Zap that one. Ooh, didn't kill it. That surprised me. I think you can target it by doing that as well. Yeah, you can. I don't know, try that. Bang. Dead. Yes, attack. Oh, come on. No, no. No missing. Damn it. It's pathetic.
Face the unending darkness.
Sorted.
Their leader said something about escaping with a stone.
Stolen from this dungeon, I imagine. Can we get inside?
Okay, we need to have a chat.
Those thieves were more than petty criminals. Their leader gave life to the dead. What stone could they have been so keen on taking?
Okay, we have a choice. We can go for our orders or say to report to our contacts in Sicil, or Sicil, whichever it's pronounced, not to waste precious time outside city walls. But we can't turn away such an odious show of source. Let's investigate the tomb. That's got to be the one.
For all we know, these dark-dealing thieves may be involved with Councillor Jake's murder.
There we go. Is that it? Just gold. A quick look over here. Oh, okay. It wants us to go into the dungeon, so we will go in the dungeon. For the YouTube video that I'll be doing over this one, just to let you know, guys, I'm actually streaming this on Twitch for a change. I normally use Hitbox, but I'm using Twitch, and I'm using the Raptor application to do it. Quality don't seem that bad, but I'm sure people will tell me if it is. So we're in a dungeon. Let's see how we're going on here. Now, did I give talk to animals to one of these? I think I did. Was it all grey? Yes!
This is where the ancient kings and queens of Sicil were buried, back before souls were banished from the land. I hear voices muttering about it now and then. Is that normal?
Alright, we got a nice squeaky voice little rat to talk to. Alright. Let's check this out. Nope. Nada. Chest locked. Which means there must be something around to open it. Is it? We find the key now. Fire arrow. Frost grenade. This grenade unleashes a chemical reaction and does 3 to 5 water damage. Okay, yeah. Have I read that? Yes. Plenty of shells. Take you.
There's a mine in the middle of our path.
Someone must have an interest in protecting whatever's kept here.
Can I use that to explode it? Hey, yes, I can. Okay. It's about the only thing it is good for. Check that. No. Adventurer's Field Guide. Let's get that. Some merchants don't give a hoot about how strong or sturdy a weapon is. They buy a mail shirt with rings the size of bracelets, as long as it looks good. Whenever I'm about to sell some old and worn down equipment, I'll simply pick a pearl on it somewhere to entice the vain and simple-minded buyers. Okie dokie. Let's organise that a little bit by type. There we go. Nothing else there. Broad skull. Bone pile. Search for key nearby. Would that be it? Yeah, it would. Yes, it would. There's the key. We got it. Augmenter. What the hell? And an old cloth cap. He hasn't got a cap on, so we can equip that straight away.
I've always heard there's typically more to a king's tomb than meets the eye.
It could be a myth, or it could be our lucky day.
Yeah, I doubt it. Check the vase. Nope. Slow down, Arrowhead. Old parchment. Tend the graves in the antechamber before moving into the inner rooms. To proceed, stand very close to the impressed door and press the button that appears on his right-hand side. Okie dokie. Very nice of you to let me know. I mean, we have done all this before. I'm hoping there is some difference. Empty. Well, we haven't talked to that rat, have we? Let's have a chat to this rat as well. See what this one's got to say. Come here. Wait. Oh, two rats. Stand still. Stand still.
Squeak! Do you like shiny gems as much as those other fellows? I admit the king's stone was pretty, but hardly as tasty as a nice crumb of stale bread. Oh well, whatever tickles your whiskers.
Okay. And what have you got to say?
I come from a long line of tomb dwellers. They say the matriarch of my clan was the first to sample the mummified flesh of the last source king.
Very nice. Okay. Right, I just need to... bring something up on my screen. On my other screen. Nope, sugar, clicked the wrong thing. That's what I wanted. Bring something. Alright, okay. And done those. What else we got? Done that. Done that. We checked all these. No, we haven't. Chest lock doesn't appear very advanced. Find a lock pick to open it. Okay, they used to be on here. Are they still there? Yes, they are. Oh. Right. Use the lock picks, Nick. Use your brain for a change. Put it in gear.
Well, what's this I've spotted?
That opens that. Oops, going into the waterfall there. Just make sure there's nothing there before we... oh, receive more key. Oh, nearly missed that then. Oh, can't get past the door. I'm not using my weapon because I'll probably wipe it out with it being only low level. There we go, nearly done. And you can finish it off.
Short work at that door, but I don't imagine our weapons would survive such use for long.
There we go. Press F5 to quick save and F8 to quick load. Okay, we'll do that because it just said it. Helps if you press the right button. Nothing there. We've got here. Rain scroll. I don't think we need to use because we have rain.
Sodden all the way to my boot soles.
missing anything there, am I? No. I know it's annoying checking out all these little vases, but we have to do just to make sure there's nothing in them. There's proof of the pudding. Have a quick word with this rat, see what he's got to say. Come here. Yeah, that's the same. Fishing rod as a weapon.
Another one for the collection.
Are they going to sit down? Yes, they are. Nice. Metal temple door key. On a chest. How did I miss that?
Careful! I've spotted a trap!
Very nearly. Check these while that poison goes, please. Thank you very much. Another key. And that's the key for that. Cloth scraps. Aged robe, okay. So look at that. A big increase. Let's have that. That's a nice gold colour, is it? Is it? A dirty brown. You only miss those? Of course, the trap disarm kit there to get rid of the trap that I obviously didn't bother with because I'm a noob. Door. Must be this. Here. Let's have a look.
I've spotted something interesting.
Ah, here we go. Place an object over the pit to stop the puddle or cloud from spreading. Okie dokie. That's that one. There was one there, that's good. Is there one here?
I've spotted something.
Missed it. Oh, good, good. No. Come back. There we go. Fuse. A grenade maker. Okay, that's something new. Smoke grenade, that's new. That might come in handy in a while when we pick up the... Oh, what was the name? Is it Bardator or something? Bard? Something like that. The Ranger. What's that? Oh.
Shh! I think I hear voices downstairs.
The last thing we need is to surprise another angry summoner.
Check this before we go into sneak. Ooh, new axe as well. Alright, thank you. Alright, see.
I feel uneasy here. I'd better keep my weapon at the ready.
Yes, you'd better, because we're going to use it, because I think that's oil that they're studying. There we go. The two enemies are concentrating in a small place. Press B to get a top-down view. Change combat highlights. B. Nah, I don't like that. Oh, she should have moved down. Damn it. There's Spidey on the job. Is that it? Come on, you could do better than that. No! Oh, I don't want to delay my turn, I want to kill it.
Death.
Thank you.
Deliverance.
Oh, you must have burned to death. Okay, what's that there? Fireball scroll. Can you drop any loots for me? Doesn't appear so.
I come from a long line of tomb.
Yes. Okay, they haven't expanded on the voices of the rats, have they? By the look of it. Check that out. Nada. Will the broken vase do it? Yes, it will. Nothing of interest there. Okay, here we go. Splitting the party. There we go. You go over there, mate. Get that one. Thank you. And you get on that one. And link them up again. Oh, I remember this. Let's go that way. Yeah, okay, I've already done that. Thank you. This dude comes out of there, doesn't he? The undead dude. Yep.
A living rat dares disturb the slumber of the dead? A thieving fool insults the sanctity of the grave. The bloodstone defiler, where is it?
Who are you?
In life, I toil to care for these holy grounds. In death, I protect them from profaners and poachers. The legacy of Cycele is mine to preserve. Her traitors are mine to destroy.
Bloodstone, I know not what you
mean. I suppose you only crept among these sacred tombs for leisure. I suppose you had no lust for the treasure of the dead. Ha! Strange indeed. Robed indeed. Your tricks will not save you from retribution, deceiver. The Bloodstone, deliver it now and I may deign to end you quickly.
I'll take my leave.
Run if you like, Defiler. Whichever way you take leads you to the grave.
In your dreams. Alright, good old Spidey, let's get him there.
Poison my foes!
Another bit of fire on him. Well, that didn't seem to do much. Oh, it did. Nearly killed him. And we can finish him.
Stay for combat!
Nice. Spidey. Yeah, take him out. Good bit of tanking there, Spidey boy. What have we got here? Let's increase. Thank you. Attack
the
him.
The force of Maxos is within me!
Ooh. Kaboom! Highlight an enemy and press right mouse button. And select examine. Oh, I don't remember that from before. Fire, -25%, crushing, -25%. Okay, that's a neat one. I like that idea. Finish him off, Spidey. Come on. Damn it. End turn.
Death never dies, fool. Death in a thousand forms rules all.
Certainly need some more skills when we get to town. Suppose I could use that a fireball. Nah, it's a waste. Spidey could do this. Yes, he can. What have we got? Old cloth cap. Thank you. Stone Great Key, Penny Bun Mushroom, Two-Handed Practice Sword. I think we know somebody that'll like that when we pick her up in town. Gravestones, that's it, I think. Right, let us exit the dungeon. The way we came up, so we need to go this way, I think. First of all, yeah. Shell, and a shovel. Some of that, bit of rope. Anything else? Shell. Gotta have good eyesight to see these things. Branch. Organize this a little bit by type. Arrow shaft. Send that to Scarlet. She hasn't got one on. Equip. Six. And that's six, no difference. Oh, I don't want to do that one yet. Need to go this way. Isn't that giant clam this way that gives you the treasure chest if you throw him back into the sea? I think he is. See, I do have a memory. Look, I might be old.
A wanderer comes my way, walking the sands upon which this poor shell must suffer.
Who are you, Sir Shell?
Call me Ishmashel, son of the sea, an outcast upon these wretched shores. An exiled shell, doomed to live under a canopy of arid sky, not his native tender water.
It seems strange that you can talk.
Of course I can talk. Don't be silly. There's more tongue to me than heart. Indeed, the surprise should be mine, for I still remember the days when your kind swung from branches and plucked the vermin out of their neighbor's fur.
Oh, dear. You don't seem to remember the past very fondly.
Time is an indulgent mistress to one who spends happy hours as she passes. But when your existence is one of misery, she becomes a lethargic hobby. Oh, I remember ancient times, for I have lain here since antiquity, when the ruins around us were palaces, and the sun-bleached dead merry children. All this I have seen, alive, alone, alas.
You say that you are doomed.
My fate is a cruel one, I assure you. How many snot noses have held me up against their dirty little ears, only to claim they can hear the ocean? Of course they can hear her, the brats. We are on the very edge of the great aquatic mother whose embrace I so desperately long for.
So is the sea's embrace you long for?
Yes, yes. I, King of Pearls, ache to repose anew on his coral throne. Hurl me toward the water. Swing me as far as your arm's strength gives lease. And treasure long sunk, I will grant thee.
I should decide what to do with
what
you.
What do you say, kind knight? Will you return the King of Pearls to the sea so he may yield you long lost treasure?
Decision time again. Kindness is its own reward. And then there's the promise of a treasure to boot. Let's throw him into the sea. Or, King of Pearls, you say, sounds lucrative. Let's sell him to the local merchant. Yeah, I'm feeling pretty kind today. I think we'll throw him back into the sea because I want the chest.
Let's send him home.
Liberator, kind benefactor, bless me the might of your sea-bound.
And there he goes. Throws a chest out of the water. Thank you very much. Alright, what do we get? What do we get? Where's he gone? There it is. Plus 11 water resistance, plus 9 HP. Yes, please. Right, I think that means we can head towards the town. Isn't that music lovely? And why's... whatever his name is, Roderick. Why's he got no health? Oh, well, health missing.
As good as a new penny.
There we go, thank you. Thank you, Scarlet. Very kind of you.
Ah.
I did get that, didn't I? Yeah, I think I did. Yeah. And off to the bridge.
Slips past the Legion unchallenged.
Calm down, Junius. Doesn't look like one of them orcs to me. Not a single horn in sight, you know.
Just hold your tongue, will you, Bibius? Can't be too careful. We are sworn to protect Sythil. We're legionnaires, of course. On the lookout for orcs, for they've been attacking from the sea. God knows why they do it, but we stand firm. We of the Legion, liberators of Rivalon.
Liberators of liquor too, aren't we, old chum?
Shh! Just pipe down, will you, Bibius?
So you are liberators, you say?
Aye. A noble word for watchdog, that. For that is what we do. Watch over the local dogs that ever so often aim for one another's throat. And separate them to keep the peace. Separate by the sword, that is.
Best way to calm a wily dog is to neuter it. Ha! Spay for pay, Legion's motto.
Just put a sock in it, will you, Bibius?
It seems you've been enjoying a drink or two.
Ever kept the watch? Stood on the lookout for hours on end, bored stiff. Boredom's a demon, buddy. And booze is the demon hunter. There. I do declare it's time for this hunter to take another shot. Huzzah!
We are here on Source Hunter's business. Here are our orders.
So, you're Source Hunters, are you? And how are we supposed to verify that's true? We can't read, my friend. So for all we know, those papers say you're a polymorph parrot on the lookout for a two-bedroom bird cage.
Polymorphed parrot.
You know what? We'll take you two to the wizard. I know he reads. He has books large as a house, that one. Yeah, he'll squeeze the truth out of you one way or another.
Okay. Right, the choice is the wizard you say sounds good to me, lead the way, or I don't need an escort, especially not a drunken one, back off or face me, which means they'll fight me, so I don't want to fight them this time. I fought them last time I played Divinity Original Sin, so we'll go the wizard way this time.
A wizard is bound to know more about what is going on around here.
Kevin, come along, we're not far from the city.
Okie dokie. Want that straight away, whatever that was.
Again, this is a single malt.
It's all cooking.
The way from Hawkesbury, you know. It ain't the local pig swill they sell for ale.
Single malt? My stubby arse. You've been had by one of them smooth-talking salesmen again. Come, give here before I sober up.
Right, what else have we got? Some mushrooms. Oh, shell. Wooden earth stuff. Oh, we'll have some of that, I think. That's better than what I'm wearing, so yes. Anything else? Hammer, yes.
What in the hell is happening down there?
Thank you.
Orcs? Bloody orcs? Come, let's go back to the bridge and the source hunters had that big bridge.
That'll come in handy. Initiate the combat. Oh, no, 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 no. Don't get yourself killed going there, youngster. That's it, come over to me. I lost health again. Target you, please. Thank you. Target's too far. Okay. Get rid of you. Come on, give me another tight. No, damn it.
Hmm.
Ooh, don't do that.
Dynamic force!
Really? Weakening spider bite. I don't remember the spider having skills. I'll try it though. Can't you reach? Nope, she can't. Get there. Nope. Ah, no AP left. Go, Spidey. Nope, out of range again. Think they might finish him off, yeah.
Did you see that? Those orcs had a human commander.
How very curious. And how very disquieting.
Okay, right. Let's do some leveling up, shall we? Right, definite. Intelligence, yes please. Abilities. Telekinesis. Don't want you to do anything else, I don't think, not on him. Leadership. Next level. I take it you need 2 points, is it, for that?
Filthy beasts, I'll kill the last one of you.
Well, let's save that for a bit, I think. Intelligence on that one. I think it's going to be the same here, actually. Unless... Lord Master, no. Yeah, hang on to those points for a little while, I think. Check all these. What have we got here? Gold. Healing potion. Anything there? Chest there.
Fire! Fire!
Oh, right, okay. Thank you very much, but we need to do something about that fire. Let's bring her over here. Yes. Right, we'll see what that weapon was. Old wooden water wand. got in. Let's equip those. Right. Let's get back to searching these bodies.
I like you much better with your guts on the floor.
Not really much of interest on these, is there?
What's this? I found something.
What is that? And why can't I pick it up? Tiny pool. Oh, there we go. Don't remember getting that last time. Right, let us head into Cecile or Cecile, however you pronounce that.
What's all this ruckus? Sounded worse than a dozen tomcats fighting over the world's last mackerel. Ah, but I see we've suffered another orc landing. And judging by the relative ease with which it was dispatched, I can only come to one conclusion. Source hunters have arrived in Cecile. You're as welcome as a glass of cooled milk on a hot day, my friend. I'm Ahu, at your service. It was I who requested your presence in this troubled city.
I was summoned here by a cat.
So you were, and so you weren't. Behold!
I'll walk out that door.
There we are. Meet my other half, Hunter. Ha ha! No need to look so flabbergasted. I may be a wizard rife with tricks and guile, but I assure you, my plea is an earnest one. So, now that the cat is out of the bag, let us turn to the matter of Counselor Jake's murder. It's hard to put my finger on it, but I can feel in my very whiskers that sorcery was at play. Visit the scene of the crime, and I'd bet sardines for salad you'll say the same. Captain Aureus, though, the local commander of the Legion, insists I'm seeing ghosts. I insist he's blind to all but the undead.
Where can I find the scene of the crime?
Jake was murdered in a downstairs room of the King Crab Inn, up in Cecile proper. The Legion keeps it under lock and key, though, so you'll need Aureus's permission should you want to have a peek.
The council has been murdered, so I assume there are some suspects.
So there are. Or rather, there is. Popular opinion has it his wife did the deed. But to be frank, I have my doubts. She seems a likely candidate, to be sure. But that would make her a sorceress. Esmeralda knows how to charm, yes, but I just don't see her magic extend beyond a frolicsome look and wink. Still, don't simply take my word for it, Hunter. It may be well worth your while to cross-examine her yourself. The Legion has her under guard in her shop near the town square. That's where you'll find poor Jake's widow.
There's something else I'd like to discuss. It may interest you to know that the orcs we took care of were led by a human.
A human, you say? Truly? But that would be like a kitten leading a wolf pack. And yet, I have heard rumors about a sect of sorts. A shadowy set of worshippers that associate even with orcs. Some say they're sorcerers, but people will say that about anyone who behaves a bit strangely nowadays. I don't quite know what to make of this news, but thank you for informing me. It'd be foolish to dismiss such a curious event out of hand.
What exactly is the trouble you're having with the undead?
Ah, the undead. They've been clawing their way out of the ground for 2 years now. And for 2 years, the stalemate between them and the living has been dragging on at a weary pace indeed. The Legion did a good job keeping them at bay, but I think it's fair to say that without my magic-infused ballistae, they'd have gotten the better of us by now. Someone is responsible for the outbreak. Necromancers are at work, but who are they and where do they hide? Alas, that searching for them is like searching for a single louse in a lion's mane.
From what I've seen and heard, this isn't the first time you've had problems with marauding orcs.
Unfortunately, that is absolutely correct. The orc siege is yet another hairball stuck in this city's already choking throat, and it shows no signs of abating. We've cordoned off the western beach where most orc activity has been reported. For the nine lives of me, I can't seem to figure what they're doing here. There's nothing of interest along the waterfront, except for a set of caves with an unfavorable reputation. Maybe they're after some pirate's treasure, the fools.
Do tell me a bit more about this cat trick of yours.
Oh, but that's not a trick. It's a blessing. Or does it surprise you that I enjoy taking a feline guy? Such magic is a gift, Hunter. To tread upon the realm of instinct. Even articulate speech, perhaps humanity's greatest asset, cannot give expression to something so inextricably innate. To be out in the night, to stalk on silent paws and hunt with only the moon as your witness. You couldn't possibly imagine the thrill. But of course, it's handy to speak in more than meows. And I couldn't brew potions or make machines without opposable thumbs. This I freely admit. Let's just say I have found a way to enjoy the best of two worlds.
I don't think I could afford to buy anything yet, but maybe we can sell something.
I said to him, I said myself, if I don't start earning an extra gold piece an hour, I'll walk out that door.
Good on you. These boss men respect confidence, you know. So what do they say?
Well, what does it matter? Day labour's more suited to my nature anyhow.
That's not going to get us anywhere, is it? Yeah, might as well get rid of them. Boom, they can be ground down. They can go. That can go.
Bringing your little orcish girlfriend here is like bringing a wolf to a henhouse. What fool would trust a two-bit love potion out of a back-page circular from youthful gore?
We shall check on the skills.
I'm glad we've met
the next time we see him.
And I'm certain we have a lot more to talk about. Feel free to visit me whenever you want. I've set up a workshop in the Legion's headquarters. Once you're there, just take the stairs. But do pay a visit to Aureus first. He may bark like a beagle with its tail stuck in the door, but you won't get very far in your investigation without speaking to the de facto leader of Sycium. And with that, I bid you adieu, Hunter. Adieu and good luck. May your enemies prove to be mere mice, and you the dauntless mouser.
Sorcery, okay, thank
sects,
you.
Undead, orcs,
in we
looks
go.
Looks like we have our work cut out for us.
At least we won't be bored. How about we go see that Aureus chap, our legend?
Yes, we will do, Scarlet. Very soon. We have all the things to do first, though. not quite sure what to do with these grenades. I think they'll be a good thing for the ranger to have. We can use it at a distance.
Oh, hail the rain spirit! That was a fine display of magicianship it was. Ah, who knew what he was doing bringing in a source hunter, didn't they? Before the old gal's fate was sealed when the orc shaman set his fiery gaze on her sails. But you managed to rescue her from a watery grave. Closest thing to a miracle I've ever seen.
Has he got anything? Well, he has. He's got a belt. Nah. We'll have a look at a later date for that. Right, what have we got here?
All hail the rain spirit. That was a fine display of magicianship, it was.
That's basically the same conversation, I think. Right, let's check all these.
Good on you. These boss men respect confidence, you know. So what do they say?
Well, what does it matter? Day labor's more suited to my nature anyhow.
Yes.
Can't get that chest yet, I don't think. I need teleport, I think. Unless I can attack it. No.
Speaking of youthful gore, that loopy source here in Sicile, bah! Of all the cursed hunks of rock to land on, Conrad chooses this one. That was some fast acting there. Many thanks on behalf of all us seamen.
Okay.
Your that loopy legionnaire really thinks that orky charm loves him.
I wouldn't let an orc within 500 yards of my loving nature.
Psst. A home, a livelihood. All sunk in a matter of minutes while we could do nothing but look on. Well, we were merchants what seems like a moment ago. With our ships sunk, we're little more than three men with nothing more to say than boo.
What happened here?
These damn orcs. They can't keep off this place for the life of them. They came in here slinging fireballs and swinging swords. Wasn't a thing we could do to defend ourselves.
About finding work.
With our ship gone, nothing for it but to get a job. Slim pickings around here, that's for sure. Maybe you can keep an eye out, though.
How about that burning ship?
That was a right stunning show of magic you pulled, it was.
I'll take my leave.
Have you found us a job yet? We'll take anything.
Alright, it's going to be the same conversation.
Curse.
What have we got here? Check Pablo, see what he's got to say for himself. Okay. There's nothing for him to say to me yet. Let's check with this dude.
Ahoy, sailor! Are you enjoying the fresh winds of Sicile? Name's Conrad. Cargo trader, sea captain, an expert in all things nautical. Folks across Andervale know to give old Conrad a holler when it comes to rare imports and magical items.
What do you think of that attack on the harbour?
Those orcs must be out of their barbarous minds launching an attack on a city where a great wizard resides. Though even I must admit they put up a heart, I'll tell you. The only time I'd consider waging a suicide campaign like that would be if whatever I sought was something worth dying over.
Let's check if he's got anything.
Speaking of youthful gore, that loopy legionnaire really thinks that orky charm loves yours here in Sicile.
Okay, nothing much there.
Psst. Ever heard about the time the captain...
I don't think we can pick those up. It's stealing, I think. Yeah, it is. It's stealing. Since we have the ability to talk to animals, let's talk to Bill.
Well, tuck my tail and call me Bessie. A 2 feet address me directly? I thought I'd never see the day. Oh, me and my brother Bull have dragged this here cart all around Sicile, from docked to graveyard and back again. Speaking of Bull, you ought to say hello to him. He's clairvoyant, you know. Can tell you fortune to the T.
I'm seeing a 2 feet approaching me, and here you are. My powers astound even me. I'm Bull, the Bull, the leading clairvoyant in Psyseal. The 2 feets never bother to ask, but I see all that is and is to be.
Can you tell me my fortune?
Of course, most winsome 2 feet. Of course. What would you like to know? Why, yes, most wealthy indeed. But you must be vigilant, 2 feet, for I see that your wealth will come by bloody means.
Oh dear. Will I be lucky in love?
Well, that depends, 2 feet. That depends. I see that love has caused you to falter in the past. Yes, falter dearly. You must reconcile your mistakes before you will find true love.
How will I die?
Death. Ever the most difficult topic to foretell. I see. Oh dear. No. Your reading is over. Do you hear? Over.
Oh dear. Who's this one? Worker. Right, check these.
Psyseal, shiver me timbers and sliver me eels.
Let's get the experience for that. Oh, we've already got it. Now, I would start the conversation with these, but I do remember that you can lure them away, but we don't have any skills as yet to even break into these or anything, so there's no point in doing that yet. We might do that at a later date, sometime in the future. So if we tried it now, it'd just be a waste of time. Yep, let's have a look at this.
Too bad indeed. Not even a skeptic like you can deny that she loves me.
One day, Moira.
When
show
this
them
little charm fades, she'll liberate the flesh from our faces.
Gonna size the orc's boobs. Isn't that ridiculous?
Cast your gaze instead upon my fair fanged filly.
Who better than a proven orc crusher to convince my dumbbell of a friend here that orcs are predators, not pets?
Is that somebody trying to try to take off Sean Connery? It is, isn't it?
Enough of that. I know how dangerous an orc can be, but this one has been reformed. Anyone can see that she's completely docile, but my prejudiced friend here still wants to kill her.
Maybe before the great orc raid we had time to indulge Ninius's idiotic obsessions.
Yes, it is.
But now we're needed at our posts. I can hardly believe I've been wasting time protecting an orc when I should be running them through.
Excuse my friend's violent outbursts. He hasn't enjoyed a woman's touch in quite some time now. It makes him a bit edgy.
Your woman's touch is less of a loving caress and more of a claw shanked brutally through the throat. I'll take my chances as a bachelor, thanks.
My friend here and I were patrolling outside the city walls when who did I see creeping along the shore but this lovely orcish lady. For a brief second, as long as eternity, we locked eyes.
Oh dear.
Perhaps confused by the butterflies in her stomach, she sprang up and began running, claws bared towards Marius. Fortunately for him, I had the presence of mind to ignore my sword and instead adroitly fling my pouch of trinkets towards her. A vial of love potion shattered over her head, and when she turned to face me, she became instantly enamored. I'm sure she must have been compelled to join the Orcish army under some kind of duress. A lady with such a sweetly savage manner would never willingly join up with those vicious marauders.
I can assure you there wasn't a hint of sweetness in those murderous eyes when she lunged at my throat. She may be confined here for now, but who's telling when she'll escape and who she'll rip to shreds?
Let me tell you what
you
I think.
See? He'd believe it was noon at midnight if he read it on a printed pamphlet. Please tell me you can reason with him, or ditch reason and use your sword to shave him from his murderous darling.
Two choices again. She could be put down. If this love potion is as dodgy as it sounds, she could come to her vicious senses at any time. Let her live. If that potion were truly worthless, she wouldn't be able to charm her in the first place. In this docile state, she may prove to be a source of valuable information. Well, she may be, but I do know from past experience that she will kill these if you don't kill her. So.
Agreed. I've never met an orc I trusted, charmed or not.
Glad to hear I'm not the only one with common sense around here. I'll do the honors myself.
No! She's harmless! Please!
There we go.
You bastard! You had no right!
No right to protect not only you from your own stupidity, but myself and the citizens of Cyseal as well.
It's you we need protection from, murderer. Fortunately, the wizards of Yuthalgor make a revenge elixir that will show you what's what.
Go ahead okay. And throw your sugar water on me if you like. Your foolishness is no longer my problem. Thank you, stranger. If you ever need help, I'll do my best to repay you.
Well, that was either a very good impersonation of Sean Connery, or it was Sean Connery doing the voiceover. Alright, that's a...
One
can't
day,
get with that.
Moira. Well, one day you'll show them all.
Thank you for talking some sense into that knucklehead. That she-beast would have been the death of us.
Right, let's head back out. I'd really like to pick up at least one companion before I finish for today.
If you are taking to the sea, leave a wide berth around that black cove.
A pan. Okay. Missing anything there, are we? Quick check over this way. Press L. Okay. I really don't know what use they will be to us, but we'll take them anyway. Don't really want to take them, I'll take them, I can sell them. Thank you. Okay, that's nice.
To meet you. Wish I was a sword hunter. Dangerous line of work, but it's a damn sight more glorious than being a legionnaire.
Crime scene, strange, what? Strange cave? I don't think we're quite ready for the strange cave yet. That's locked. Yeah, I don't want to go that way yet, we'll go this way. What's this? That's locked. The forge and everything that we can use if we need to. We're not going out there yet. We are nowhere near ready. Use that to grind some bones down, I think. I'm going the right way here.
Dear me. Oh, how the coast. Oh, how nice it is of you. The very picture of youth. To break the monotony of an elder's day. Wild away on this hardwood bench. Pray, let me be forward with you, O sapling rose, O leaf of spring, for my weary mind is troubled and would highly prize thy gentle-handed assistance, thy kind ministrations.
Tell me more about yourself.
I am but an aged elf that has seen the years parade in long succession. Gladly shall I tell you more. Will I regale thee, O whelp of men, with my tale? But not here, where the winds may steal my words.
About the assistance you asked of me.
You would listen to my grievances, guide me towards untroubled realms. Oh, you are truly a wonder, oh, budding flower of the morn. Yet, that which I would tell you is of a rather private nature. So let us escape both the chill and the eye of public scrutiny. Hot spiced wine and a snug little room awaits us on the King Crab's first floor. Let us go there, so that we can warm our bones, yet make shiver our hearts with a tale of loss and sorrow.
Okay. See you in a few days. I think. What's around here? I don't remember this. Nothing. All right, okay. That's there. Graveyard, don't want that yet. I think we need to go this way first. Let's go and check out the inn, I think.
Not in the mood for cheese!
You there! A moment of your indulgence, if you please. You are the source hunter, are you not? The hero the whole of Sycyl is abuzz about. The talk of the town. The juiciest grape on the grapevine. Such a pleasure to meet you. A delight. No, scratch that. It is so much more than a delight. It is an intervention of fate. Yes, that's it. Fate has put me on this very spot so I may tell you all about a most intriguing opportunity indeed.
And you are?
Mendius, at your service. What is my profession? Well, I'll tell you what it used to be, and that is a man of medicine. But what does a man of medicine do but mend what has first been broken? I saved lives, to be sure, but today, I change them.
About the opportunity you mentioned.
Oh, it's not merely an opportunity. It is a once-in-a-lifetime chance to become better. To become the full extent of the promise that is locked inside of each and every one of us. So first of all, let me ask you this question. Do you like adventure?
Excuse has more holes than a slice of this fine Corman bear.
Fresh haddock, perfect for
quite
fire.
Right. Adventure is what we live for.
See here, you and I share the same passion. I never doubted it for a moment. The thrill of walking the unbeaten path, the rush of finding yourself in a goblin ambush, knowing you'll prevail nonetheless. Too bad your line of work comes with such measly recompense. Am I right? The wage of a mere soldier. Now, between you and me, tell me truthfully, don't you sometimes wish you could earn more?
Well, I can't say that I haven't.
Yes, some extra gold is always welcome.
Indeed. Indeed, gold is always welcome. And among the Fabulous Five, gold flows as freely as water does to the sea. Even so, my friend, matters of a pecuniary nature aside, what is life without variety, without spice? To be a source hunter must get frightfully dreary sometimes. Am I right? All those orders. Investigate this, retrieve that. And at the end of the day, what do you have to show for it? Wouldn't you prefer to call your own shots? Be your own boss?
It's better to lead than to follow, that much is true.
Better to be served than to serve. I concur.
Well spoken. Well said indeed. Life's too short to spend it doing someone else's bidding. Am I right? Of course I am. And I could help you attain the dream. Enact the change you deserve. And that is exactly why I am here. Why fate has put me right by the door to the King Crab. so that I could meet you and tell you about the marvel that is the Fabulous Five. The invitation to join is yours. Grab it. They call the undead a problem, my friend, but those who know the ways of the Fabulous Five see no problems. They see opportunities. An enterprising spirit can wrench riches from cold dead rocks, or from cold dead full stop.
Tell me more about the Fabulous Five.
The Fabulous Five. How I enjoy simply saying the words that describe the most illustrious and celebrated adventurers' guild in Riverlon. Our mission, to better the world. Our mantra, to better ourselves as we do so. To realize our dreams and cleanse our souls. You'd like nothing more than to enlist, wouldn't you? Of course you would. And you can. Of course, if you still have questions, I shall answer them to the best of my abilities. But if not, how about we get started?
So what is it that the members of the Fabulous Five actually do?
What a gem of a question. Straight as an arrow. Sharp as a switchblade.
What a con man.
Most meritorious of you. Now then, to join the Fabulous Five is to join a fellowship. To join a fraternity, a sorority, a community. The title of knight is bestowed upon you the moment you sign our waiver, and so it all begins. I shall be the one to give you your first contracts, and once the job is done, I shall see to it you get your fair share of the reward. Of course, should you spread the word, should you propagate the gospel of the Fabulous Five and thereby draw new knights into our fellowship, you will get a share of the reward from their contracts too. Isn't that wonderful?
It's a pyramid system.
By now, the genial glow of the fellowship must have warmed your heart. It has, hasn't it? But did I say fellowship? I mean family. For like a family, we support one another, cheer one another, see each other through thick and thin, partake in glory and defeat, work hard,
good, get on with contracts, it.
Enlist new knights, and swiftly shall you rise through the ranks. You will better yourself. You will better Riverlon. You will make the stars shine all the brighter, and you'll get fabulously wealthy in the process. What's not to like?
Okay, I'd like to enlist.
Of course, of course, of course. All you need to do is sign this waiver, and just like that, snap, you're part of the family. All I need is your lovely little autograph. What do you say?
And me. May all the riches in the world be ours.
Marvelous. Magnificent. Oh, but what am I saying? Fabulous is the word. You may not realize it yet, but your fortunes, your very life is about to change for the better. So let us not dilly-dally. To business. Your first assignment is ready and waiting if you're ready and willing. You found new recruits already? Efficient. Proactive. Oh, I like that. Send them to me and I'll sign them up. And of course, since they're your recruits, you'll get a share of every assignment they complete. Isn't that just fabulous?
Hmm. Yes, it's also a load of bull. I'll take my leave.
Not in the mood for cheese.
Oh, I didn't do the assignment, did I? About my assignment.
It's a pretty straightforward task, this one. Now, in this town dwells a wizard. Ahu is his name, and he's a frightful eccentric. Scientific type, you know the kind. Favors reason over faith and all that. Not Fabulous Five material, him. His experimental weapons may keep a couple of skeletons away from the city, but many of his other researches failed. Malfunctioned, with tragic consequences. One of them was a big lumbering apparatus. A frightful automaton shaped like a giant made of steel. It was supposed to crush the undead by the dozens.
piloted, as it was, by a trained legionnaire. But you can guess what happened. Did it become sentient? Was it cursed? Whatever the cause, the thing relieved itself of its pilot and headed north towards a network of caves. Now ask yourself, what if it comes back? It could smash the city walls and claim 100 lives before being subdued. Luckily, there are those in this world who belong to the Fabulous Five, the Braves who eat such monstrosities for breakfast. Go, my friend. Find this wizard's abomination and claim your just reward from Mayor Cecil in the name of our hallowed guild. Easy money.
Okay. Log updated. Fabulous Five. Excuse me. Right. Let's see if we can find somebody to recruit, shall we? And there she is.
Back, demon. Back, or I'll.
Hello, Midora.
Midora, you lummox. A thousand pardons, comrade. This old bear's edgier than a dodecahedron these days. I'll tell you, it sure does me good to set eyes on another of our order. From Academy West, aren't you? Give Captain Wartruce my regards next time you see him.
Alistair, have you ever had the fortune of challenging?
You wouldn't. I trained up in Academy North, after all. We don't cross paths with you Westies all that often, but it's always a pleasure when we do. Medora's the name. Retired, or so the Order keeps trying to tell me, but never out of commission. My hand to your cause and my sword at your side.
I hadn't heard of another source hunter being assigned to Cycele. What are you doing here?
Heaven's hornets! That's quite a story, comrade. And come to think of it, one that might concern you. See, I'm here on, well, let's call it a loan from a town to the north of here. Hunter's Edge by name. There's been an attack there, comrade. Orcs. Not your run-of-the-mill savages either. But ones who've taken dark magic to new heights. What they want in Hunter's Edge, I can't say. But it's my responsibility to send them packing. Preferably with their horns in their suitcases and a knee-knocking fear of ever crossing paths with a sauce hunter again. I came south seeking the Legion's help. Only to find it tied here in Cycele. They don't have a spare soldier to send northward, and even in my finest form, I can't clear the place of that many orcs without backup.
Orcs attack your village? How did you manage to escape?
By the skin of my teeth, comrade. The savages were rounding up villagers when one of them activated a tripwire on our village wizard's property. Fortunately for me, that particular wizard has a penchant for things that go boom in the night. I managed to wrench free of my captor's grip and flee toward the forest. He pursued me for miles, but I'd lost him before I made it into the Cycele hinterlands.
What's your next plan of attack?
Well, comrade, I hadn't thought of it till you tapped my shoulder just now. But perhaps that's where you come in. I need a contingent I can trust if I'm to take back the town. And the way I see it, you could use reinforcements here in town. I've been scouting Cycele for some time now, and I believe I've sussed out sufficient intel to help solve the murder of the counselor. With our minds and swords in tandem, we'll make short work of the perpetrator.
So that's your proposition to help us here in Cycele?
The likes of which I doubt you could even fathom, old friend.
What evidence of source inside you have earned thus far?
Well, you know the old expression. Two's a tea party, three's an invasion. I know this place like the back of my hand by now. And the orcs up north will be short work for a trained up trio of sauce hunters.
Okay. A fantastic plan with three sauce hunters working in tandem will put an end to all evils bent against his fair land. That sounds good. We can't a good conscious take on Cycele farming for our current mission, we'll take that.
Another source hunter on the team will make us all the more formidable against this wicked magic. Welcome aboard, Medora.
That's the spirit. Listen closely now.
Do you hear it? That's the sound of every orc and sorcerer in a 100-mile radius shaking in his wee boots.
Ah, there we go. We have Medora. Let's have a look at what she's got. Nothing. We got a sword for her. I think we have. Sent to Medora.
Do I seem like the sort who concerns myself with such things?
You'll be concerned enough when you realize that reward honey won't be
lying to Medora. I don't think they'll be any good, so let's have a look. Medora. 45 to 56, she's currently equipped. These are no good whatsoever. Great. Selling stuff then. Need that there. I need to get rid of that.
Have you ever had the fortune of challenging the fabled wizard of Hunter's Edge?
Fortune? Ha!
I'm afraid that's the end for today, I think.
He's privy to ancient and arcane.
Thanks very much for watching.
The likes of which I doubt you could even.
But it's time to log off. I'm going to do some real life stuff. So I'll see you again sometime. It's all Grey signing off.